Hey guys, it's Nick. Welcome to another episode of T-365. Today's episode, we're covering the updates from Microsoft in October of 2023. If you followed along in the past, you know I focused in on much relevant to the MSP space, blocking out the noise of the 100 or so announcements that come from Microsoft each month. As a quick reminder, I always supplement this video with a blog post down below with more information about all these announcements, helpful links, videos, things like that. So be sure to check that out after we get through here. Getting into it though, we're going to start off with Microsoft Teams as we usually do. So first is a really cool feature, I think, where you can now forward messages from one chat or channel to another. And as you can see in some of these screenshots, you're actually able to give more context about that message before you send it over. So this is just a nice, really nice feature, I think, just to share messages across chats and channels. This will happen mid-January 2024. Next one here is private team discovery. So this is giving you as an admin the ability to scope a certain amount of users that have access to be able to search for private channels when they go to, say, join a team within the team's experience. You can limit this to a subset of your users there, and they still will have to request to join that channel, but it will be discoverable in the team's experience. So this will happen early January and be complete by mid-January. Next one here is just really nice to have, I think, from a convenience standpoint. It's addition of a chat button in the missed call activity. So instead of having to maybe search for that user internally and go to a chat message from there, you'll now just have a chat button to really redirect you immediately into chatting with that user. This will happen late November and be complete by early December. Next announcement here is related to an integration in Microsoft Teams with Microsoft Designer. If you're not familiar with Designer, it's kind of like a DALL-E experience where you're using generative AI to curate and describe what kind of an image you would want, and it spits that out as part of the output. So this is involving the announcements feature with the Microsoft Teams, where you're able to add, you know, a certain headline or placeholder as far as the image goes. This will give you the ability to curate, as you can see in the right-hand screenshot, the image itself by giving it a description. So pretty cool. This will happen early November, be complete by mid-November. Next one here is the ability to set out of office from the Teams mobile application. This previously wasn't available on mobile, but it will be now on iOS and Android. This will happen in mid-October, be complete by late October. So by the time you're watching this video, it's likely already out for you. Next one here is also a Teams mobile feature, but it's giving the ability to quickly capture the screen within the mobile experience itself. So imagine you're taking notes, wanting to grab screenshots of slides, things of that nature, giving you the ability to do that, push that into your photo gallery or share within Teams as well too, just in another experience. This will happen early November and be complete by late November. Next one here is a Teams premium feature, so not available to everybody, but it's a nice security feature for end-to-end encrypted meetings for Microsoft Teams. Previously, they had this in Teams premium, but it was only up to 50 participants. Now we're moving up to 200 participants. This isn't directly related to SMB, I think, as far as a popular feature. We wanted to call it out there because you probably have some clients that have to meet certain regulatory compliance needs or are in government, things like that, that you may want to look to implement this in. This is going to happen late October, be complete by early November. Last one here for Microsoft Teams is related to this integration with Microsoft Loop. If you're not familiar with Loop, I like to describe it as an alternative to a Notion or Evernote as far as a note-taking type of software, but it does give you a lot of enhanced collaboration features. I think it's going to be more popular in the coming months and years as more people get to adopt it and enhances its feature set, but this is allowing you to embed these Loop components directly within Teams channels as well. And those can be things like tables that you're all working on, part of things of that nature, where you're just enhancing the collaboration overall and the flexibility in which you collaborate. So this will happen late November, be complete by late December. Shifting into Entra ID here, I have three larger security updates from Entra, which are really cool. This first one does require P2 licensing because we're talking about the PIM enabled integration with both groups, as well as activating certain roles or involving conditional access. So when we talk about the group enhancement, you can see that in the left-hand diagram here where you can PIM enable a group where users can have access to certain roles or applications or things like that, and they can elevate themselves into that group with just-in-time access to those resources so they don't have that perpetual footprint. Same is true on involving PIM with conditional access, where you could say, if you want to activate this global administrator role, I want to use phishing resistant MFA, like a FIDO 2 key or something like that, versus just any MFA. So it's a really cool integration. This is available now, so you can begin to check that out. If you enable PIM and set up the settings, you'll be able to see these as options there. Another security feature here is the introduction of this Microsoft Graph activity log. So previously we have obviously sign-in logs and audit logs that we can view within the Entra ID Admin Center. This is extending that to see more of this verbose detail, like the token requests and sign-in logs, the API requests that are going on. And where this is more applicable is if you have maybe a compromised user, you want to see everything that they're doing and all the activity that they performed, or maybe you want to audit certain integrations like third-party applications that have hooks into your Microsoft environment and see exactly what they're doing within your environment as a whole. These can also push out word as an external API, so you can say, I want to push this into an external SIM or get it into my SIM tool. That's another enhanced security feature here. It's in public preview, no announcements yet on GA, but this does require at least a P1 license as well. This one here also requires a P2 license. I know we're not a lot of people getting into that with SMB, but wanted to call it out because there's really cool security features in here. This one is using this governance access reviews, and access reviews you can use to leverage against teams, applications, as well as various groups as well too, to see, does this person still need access to this? You can do this also with Azure AD roles within there, but this is specifically looking in at certain settings that they've involved or included, which allow you to quickly identify users who haven't signed in within a certain time frame. So in this case, they show 30 days, and you can identify that, and they're giving you this as a recommendation to rip the user out because they're inactive as well. So a cool feature available now as well too. You can check that out. Shifting into Microsoft Intune here, this is a really cool feature in my mind because this is involving Security Copilot within Intune. You'll see here in this video diagram of the feature, you're actually just using plain text to search and identify data within your environment, in this particular case, that's Intune. So in this case, we're looking at device compliance for a user and seeing what policies are being applied. But this is, in my mind, where I was thinking we were going ahead with large language models, being able to tap into the AI component while leveraging plain text to really search your graph API data behind the scenes with Microsoft. So you can sign up for early access or try to get into the early access program here. Obviously, this is going to be additional cost as far as the licensing goes, but I think it's a really cool and powerful feature here that they're going to introduce. This is one of the plays of maybe how quickly can you speed up your investigation time with these security incidents, or just investigation as a whole with this searching capability. Last section here is related to Microsoft admin section. So first one here is related to universal print with Microsoft Business Premium. Previously, you only had 5 print jobs per month as a user. Now you get 100 print jobs per month. As far as the adoption of universal print, I still think that's lower because it still needs some enhancements. But if you are on Business Premium, previously you had to have some additional licensing to get more print jobs. They're trying to have this all encompassed here. So for the average SMB, I think for 100 print jobs per user per month is probably something that's feasible versus 5 like you had previously. So that one is available starting November 14th, as you can see there. Something you want to check out if you're using Universal Print today. Next one here is related to a security related focus for Microsoft, where they're going to start hard enforcing PIN-based verification for support callers. This is directly related, in my opinion, to the MGM attack. And they had this since 2020, but they're going to be enforcing that now. They'll verify via email or phone. So you can go update your profile information in there to make sure you have the most up-to-date contact information in the admin center, as well as supplementing that PIN here as well. It will be hard enforced starting on November 1st, so coming into this next month here. Last one here, 2022 LR2 has reached the end of support. If you're still on this, I know there's probably tons of people still on this. Legacy days of me doing migrations from these types of environments, I still saw a ton in the ecosystem. But it's reached end of support effective October 10th, so well past that now. There are the ESUs, the extended security updates available that you can purchase up until 2026. But again, I think the better course of action here would be to go look at an upgrade path into Windows Server 2022. So definitely want to check that out if you have any of these in your ecosystem. But that was all the announcements I wanted to cover for you guys today. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. Otherwise, as always, like and subscribe if you guys want to see more content around Microsoft and the MSP space. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.